मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अ वॉर्म वेलकम टू यू ऑल इन इंग्लिश लेक्चर. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड रिवाइज आवर ग्रामर टॉपिक्स विच आर देयर ट्रांसिटिव इंट्रांसिटिव ऑफ फिगर्स ऑफ स्पीच एंड एडजेक्टिव. सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड रिवाइज द ग्रामर टॉपिक्स. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to revise the lessons. As you all know, as we have completed the syllabus for our unit test, so we'll revise the lessons which we have studied in previous lecture. So for this purpose, I request you all to kindly take out your English textbook, English notebook, pen, pencil in your hand. Yes. Now, so students, as you all know, we have completed the syllabus of Unit 1. So, this Unit 1 will be there for your first unit test. So, total 6 chapters are there in Unit 1. And in today's lecture, we'll revise it one by one. So, are you ready for that? Very good. Let's start with the first poem, Past, Present, Future. So, dear students, in this poem, who is the poet? Very good, Emily Bronte. Now, in the poem Past, Present and Future, the poet Emily Bronte asks her child what the past, present and future looks like to him. And in an innocent manner, the child describes the nature that he associates with each of these time frames. Now, when the poet asks the innocent child about his past, first stanza. In first stanza, the poet asks the child about his past, and the child, who is smiling, says that it is like an autumn evening where the wind lets out a breath in grief. The past for the child is something that he remembers with longing and a little sadness. Next, in second stanza, you can see the poet asks the happy child or innocent child about the present. So when the poet asks about the present hour, the child says that it is like a springtime with greenery and flowers around, where a young bird's on a branch of tree is just learning to fly. And in this manner, the present for the child is full of possibilities and something he wants to take chances in. He is gathering his strength and looking forward to head into the world. Sea that has stretched far and wide under the bright sun. Now, in third stanza, the poet asks the happy child about his future, and on being asked about the future, the child compares the future with a sea under a cloudless sun, a sea which is mighty, glorious, dazzling and never ending. So according to him, the future is magnificent, exciting and mysterious, and he is keep on exploring it. So, through these words, he implies about the thrilling and never-ending possibilities which await him. So, students, as you all know, in the poem, in exam, it can be asked the rhyming words, rhyming scheme and figures of speech. So, just go through the notes which I have given you all in written in your notebook. It will help you all in unit test, in exam. Now, let's proceed to the next chapter, So now let's move towards the second chapter, Odd One In. Now in this chapter, Odd One In is an excerpt from the book of the same name by Tithi Tavora. Set against the backdrop of challenges encountered by a newcomer in school. So this story highlights the importance of inner beauty as compared to outward appearance. Now, which are the two main characters of this chapter? Do you remember? Yes. Malti and Reema. Malti and Reema are the two main characters of the story. So, the story revolves around Reema, a city girl who tried to bully a new student in her class. Malti, who was from a different state, she took the admission in Reema's school and she was different from Reema and her friends. So, unlike them, she applied oil in her hair, bindi on her forehead and did not speak English fluently. So, for this purpose, Reema and her friends began to make fun of Malti. And rather than helping her to get accustomed to their school, Reema and her friends tried to begin making fun of Malti because she belongs from the village. As time passed, everybody in the class realized how talented and sweet Malti was and befriended her. So, however, Reema continued to tease her. This hurt Malti and one day she could not tolerate it anymore. She ran away from Reema with tears in her eyes and Reema's friend scolded her for her behavior. Reema then understood her mistake, but she was too proud to accept it even to herself. So the story tells us that we realize that we are at fault. We should apologize immediately and make things right. So, Reema learns a lesson not to judge anyone by their outward appearance and be respectful to one and all. But does she really learn the lesson? What do you think? Yes, Reema learned a lesson. Although she was very proud of her, but she learned a lesson that not to judge anyone by their outward appearance. And besides, even if someone does not speak good English, it can always be learned and improved on, but not to judge anyone by the outward appearance. So dear students, this is the story of Reema and Malti, where Reema, she belongs from a city and Malti belongs from village. So Reema was very smart, good looking, and in front of her Malti was poor and her appearance was totally different from city life. So this was the reason Reema used to bully along with her friends. She used to bully Malti for a simple looks and dressing sense. And Reema was quick to judge the newcomer. So dear students, in this story, we learned that we should never judge anyone by their looks, by their appearance, by their behavior. We should be friendly with everyone. Clear with this? Now let's proceed to the next chapter. Let us revise the poem In Time of Silver Rain, written by the poet Langston Hughes. So dear students, this poem 1.3, page number 8 of your textbook, is very interesting poem. So this poem is an expression of joy and beauty of nature that spring brings along with it.
filling our hearts with wonderment at the newness of life. So in the poem, In Time of Silver Rain, the poet Langston Hughes paints a vivid imagery of rains during springtime. He elaborates in his simple yet effective style the majestic spread of life in nature. Grasses and flowers stretching across green vistas act as symbols of newness in nature. So through the poem In Time of Silver Rain, the poet Langston Hughes wants to portray how rain adds to the magnificence and the beauty of everything around us. The poet says that the water droplets shine when they fall from the sky and look as if they are silver in color. So he says that because of rain, our planet gets a new life. After the harsh and scorching summer, the dried grass and pale flowers regain their lustrous color. The return of different colors of nature light up the land and leave us in wonder of the beauty of life. The poet further says that as a rainbow forms in the sky, the butterflies also spread their wings and begin to fly. It looks as if they have caught the radiant colors of rainbow. You have known the 7 colors of rainbow. They are so pretty, so beautiful. So when the butterflies fly in the sky, it seems as if they have caught all the radiant colors of the rainbow on their delicate and soft wings. The leaves of trees that fall in the autumn grow back, and the spatter of raindrops on them makes it seem as though they are shining and singing. Rain has its impact not only on flora and fauna but also on people. The poet further says that when you walk down the road, when the passing boys and girls go singing too, when they pass by on the road, the young boys and girls also cheerfully singing and enjoying the rain. The poet concludes by talking about the season of spring after it rains. The arrival of spring signifies rebirth and the beginning of a fresh life. And because of the rain and spring, life as we know it also starts afresh. So the boys and girls sing merrily as they walk down the road in the rains at the onset of spring season. The happiness in nature is so contagious that it extends to human beings as well. So, dear students, I request you all that in today's lecture, as we have revised the 3 chapters of your Unit 1, that is past, present, future. This was the poem. Second, the lesson, odd one in. And third, poem In Time of Silver Rain. So, I request you all to kindly go through all the poems and chapters and the notes which I have given in your notebook, so that it will be helpful for you all in exam.